हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ एडवांस डायग्नोस्टिक टेक्निक्स। सो कंटिन्यू फोर जनरेशन प्रोब्स। फोर जनरेशन रिफर्स टू थ्री डायमेंशनल प्रोब्स करेंटली अंडर डेवलपमेंट। दीज प्रोब्स आर एम्ड एट रिकॉर्डिंग सिक्वेंशियल प्रोब पोजिशंस अलॉन्ग द जिंजाइवल सल्कस। दे आर एन अटैम्प्ट टू एक्सटेंड लीनियर प्रोबिंग इन अ सीरियल मैनर टू टेक इन टू अकाउंट द कंटिन्यूस एंड 3D पॉकेट बींग एग्जामिन्ड। Fifth generation probes. Despite all the advances in earlier generation probes, they remain invasive and at times their use can be painful to patients. Plus, with these earlier generation probes, the probe tip usually crosses the junctional epithelium. Fifth generation probes are being devised to eliminate these disadvantages. Probes are being designed to be 3D and non-invasive. An ultrasound or other device is added to a fourth generation probe. Fifth generation probes aim to identify the attachment level without penetrating it. The ultrasonographic probe, the only fifth generation probe available, uses ultrasound waves to detect, image and map the upper boundary of the periodontal ligament and its variation over time as an indicator of the presence of periodontal disease. The ultrasonographic probe was devised by Hinders and Companion at the NASA Research Center. This small intraoral probe has an ultrasound beam projection area close enough in size to the width of the periodontal ligament space to give the optimal coupling and is small enough to inspect the area between the teeth, while still delivering sufficient signal strength and depth of penetration to image the periodontal ligament space. To probe these structures ultrasonically, a narrow beam of ultrasonic energy is projected down between the tooth and bone from a transducer, which is scanned manually along the gingival margin. This is an ultrasonographic probe. Non-periodontal probes. Calculus detection probe. Calculus detection probes detect subgingival calculus by means of audio reading and are reported to increase chances of subgingival calculus. Currently, the DetectR probe is the only calculus detection probe on the market. This device has a lightweight, well-balanced handpiece which can be autoclaved and it produces an audible beep to signify calculus detection. Halitosis. Halitosis or oral malodor is most often caused by gram-negative anaerobic bacteria which degrades the proteins and produce volatile sulfur compounds. These sulfur compounds can be detected by gas chromatography or the recently halimeter by Rosenberg et al. In 1991. The halimeter is compact, easy to use and allow chair-side testing. Its performance lacks specificity in the analysis of the different components of mouth air in comparison to the gold standard gas chromatography with flame photometric detection. This is a halimeter. Next is diamond probe. This is a recently developed commercially available instrument developed by the Diamond General Development Corporation. It has been designed so that it combines the features of a periodontal probe with the detection of volatile sulfur compounds in the periodontal pocket. It's a diamond probe. Periotest. Tooth mobility is a clinical expression of periodontitis. The periotest is one of the current systems to assess tooth mobility. It utilizes dynamic forces of short duration of low millisecond range. It evaluates the damping characteristics of the tooth. The device consists of a handpiece that is connected to a unit via cable. Inside the handpiece, a metal rod is accelerated until it reaches its nominal speed and contacts the tooth. The tooth is slightly deflected and the rod is reclated. Using the measured contact times in milliseconds, the periotest values are calculated. The following ranges are recorded: 8 to 9 clinically firm tooth, 10 to 19 palpable mobility, 20 to 29 visible mobility, 30 to 50 mobility in response to lip and tongue movements. Errors may occur due to variation in duration, point of application, mode of application, manner and duration and time of forces, or due to instability variation, slippage of device, etc. Advances in radiographic diagnosis. First, digital radiography. Advantages: they can be manipulated on the computer screen to aid in the diagnosis by changing density, contrast, and magnification. Physical principle: in the conventional film-based radiography, the film serves as both detector and storage medium, whereas digital detectors are used only to generate the digital image, which is then stored on a digital medium. Digital imaging comprises four separate steps: generation, processing, archiving, and presentation of the image. A standard X-ray tube generates X-rays, which are then exposed to the sensor placed in the oral cavity. We have two kinds of digital radiography technology: direct and indirect. Direct digital radiography technology. This technology uses an X-ray generator and a solid state image receptor, more commonly referred to as a sensor. A sensor is made up of a silicon chip which is sensitive to light and has a scintillator layer that converts X-rays to light. There are two solid state sensor technologies in the market today. First, charged coupled device, and second one is complementary metal oxide semiconductor. Charge coupled device. In the case of charge coupled device, usually silicon is used as the base material and silicon dioxide is used as the coating. The final top layer is also made of silicon or polysilicon. An image is derived from a charge coupled device in four steps: the charge generation, charge collection, charge transfer, and charge measurement. When the sensor is exposed to X-rays, the charge is generated in the silicon chip of CCD device. This charge is then collected and transferred to a system which measures the charge and generates a meaningful image. Complementary metal oxide semiconductor. Both CMOS and CCD share common principles of physics, but CMOS differs from CCD in terms of chip microarchitectures. In a complementary metal oxide semiconductor chip, more of the electronic components controlling the conversion of photon energy into the electronic signal are incorporated into the chip itself. Indirect digital radiography technology. This technology uses image plates having a detective layer of photostimulable crystals that contain different halogenides such as bromide, chlorine, or iodine. When X-rays are exposed on these photostimulable crystals, they absorb their energy by bringing their electrons to higher energy levels. These electrons may stay at a higher energy level for several hours depending on the specific physical properties of the phosphor crystals used. The next step involves the scanning of the image plate with laser beam. This converts the energy stored in the photostimulable crystals into light. An array of photomultipliers collects the light, which is converted into electrical charges by an analog to digital converter. The digitally converted raw information in the form of electrical charges is now converted into a meaningful image by the software. Advantages of digital radiography. There are multiple advantages of digital radiography over conventional radiography. These are: reduced exposure to X-ray radiation as compared to conventional films, A superior grayscale resolution of 256 colors of gray in comparison to 16 to 25 shades of gray on a conventional film. Next, colorization and enlargement of the images can be done with digital images. Provides freedom of manipulation of contrast, sharpness, image orientation and pseudo color. Decrease processing time. Storage of radiographs into the small hard device of the computer is a great space saver in comparison with an extra sheet of radiographs. Digital images can be easily transmitted to other dental offices. Digital radiography is environmental friendly because there are no disposal hazards or processing chemicals, silver salts in film emulsion and lead foil sheets. During implant placement, using conventional film disrupts entire aseptic procedure and also time is wasted while the clinician awaits the development of the film several times during the procedure. Subtraction radiography. As the name indicates, subtraction radiography involves detection of areas of changes in bone density and volume on two serially obtained radiographs of a particular site. Detected as lighter areas bone gain or darker areas bone loss. Radiographs taken with identical exposure geometry can be scanned using microphotometer that determines a gray level value of for each picture point. Limitations of subtraction radiography. For successful subtraction radiography, reproducible exposure geometry and also identical contrast and density of the serial radiographs are essential prerequisites. And long experience shows that this technique is very sensitive to any physical noise occurring between the radiographs. Digital subtraction radiography (DSR) allows the detection of small changes in alveolar bone. Weber et al. In 1982 introduced digital subtraction into dental radiography. The technique simply involves subtraction of pixels of one image from another with the same projection geometry, where radiographs are taken at a specified time apart. In DSR, this calibration can be accomplished by changing contrast, brightness, and gamma values of the image. Digital imaging software commonly include a histogram tool as well as tools for the adjustment of brightness and contrast. Computer assisted densitometric image analysis (CADIA). Evaluation of the bone density is an important part of the treatment planning, especially during dental implant treatment. Bone quality and volume can be analyzed by various techniques such as intraoral and panoramic radiographs, cone beam and microcomputed tomography, dual energy X-ray absorptiometry, MRI, quantitative ultrasound and laser Doppler flow cytometry. The most widely used densitometric method in implantology is CADIA. The equipment used in CADIA includes a video camera which interfaced with an image processor and a computer that allows the storage and mathematical manipulation of the images, measures the light transmitted through our radiographs and converts the signals from the camera into gray levels. CADIA is capable of detecting minimal variations in the mineralized tissue density after various procedures, such as after flap surgery, the healing process in the furcation area after regenerative procedures, and changes in bone density around implants over a period of time. Computed tomography. The word tomography comes from Greek words tomos, means slice, and graphic means to write. So, tomography literally means writing slices. It is a technique of reconstructing a cross-sectional image of the body from our X-ray photographs. In this scan, the patient remains stationary on the examination table while the X-ray tube rotates in a circular orbit around the patient in a plane perpendicular to the length axis of the patient.